Right now we're in the middle of our DNA unit. We can get you caught up, but I need you in class every single day. No ifs, ands, or buts. Actions speak louder than words.
Sarah Rivas is in trouble. She's failing several classes because she hasn't been to school in a month.
I do think that you're one of the most capable students.
If she were part of the general population at Andrew Hill High School, her teachers might simply write her off. But she's a member of the school's Biotech Academy, a close-knit family of at-risk students and dedicated teachers for whom failure is not an option.
This has got to change. Do I need to call Mom? Honest, if you want me to call Mom, then I won't. Okay, is this going to change?
Yes.
Okay, when?
Today.
And if not?
Then I'll be out of biotech.
So?
And I won't go to college, and I probably won't graduate.
So?
And that matters to me.
Graduating from biotech has changed the lives of hundreds of students since the academy was founded on Andrew Hill High School's San Jose campus in 1999.
Okay, remember how it works. The stopcock, if it's going left to right, is closed. Up and down is open.
Biotech Academy is sort of the cornerstone of the school, our trademark.
45 minus...
And we wanted to provide opportunities for students who were, you know, in that category of maybe marginal or at risk, because our concept was if you have a program that these students can be connected to, that's going to increase the probability that they're going to stay in school and matriculate to their 2 or 4 year college university.
Each fall, 50 sophomores enter the 3-year academy program, which features an interdisciplinary curriculum focused on bioscience. Juniors are hooked up with mentors at local biotechnology companies, and as seniors, they present the results of self-designed experiments.
Our first lab was actually getting the rats and putting them in the tanks.
While only 30% of the school's general population goes on to college, the rate for Biotech Academy students is 95%.
Can you see that?
No, really.
Can you see the paper in front of you?
Yeah.
Good.
Much of the credit for the Academy's success goes to a unique team of teachers.
Imperialism in Africa.
The teachers in this program were handpicked. Criteria was, first, that they were high-energy communicators that understood how to reach kids.
The English come down, and they're like, move over to the Dutch, move over, move over. And the Dutch are like, go ahead. The Dutch are like, move back. And so they're going to end up doing what? What are the English and the Dutch going to be doing? Fighting.
The relationship that we have with these kids is completely unique. The way we speak, what are you doing? Where are you going? Why aren't you supposed to be in class? Let me see your grades. What are you doing? They respond. For some reason, it works with them.
Okay, so this is what we're going to do. We have to figure out what is the concentration of an unknown acid. Okay. It's kind of hard because basically you have such a wide range from kids that are extremely intelligent, just aren't trying, to kids that need a lot of hand-holding. Okay, last class still is confused, so we'll try it again. Unknown acid, okay. Coming from the suburbs of Chicago, I did not grow up the same way as these kids are growing up. So it's very difficult for me to relate lots of times. Like there was a time last year where a kid came in, didn't do his homework. Why didn't you do your homework? My family got evicted, we had to move to a car, we're living in the car. So you're like, hand it in later. You know, it's like, you know, what are you gonna say? You can't be angry at the student, the child, because it's not their fault.
McCarthy is a senator. So that's the Senate hearings. What's the other part of our government, or the Congress?
My role is more, I think, in some respects, the guns, the enforcer. I get to get in people's faces. I get to yell. I chase them down. I'm checking on attendance. If they're cutting a class, I'm going to find them. I have high expectations of their behavior, of their schoolwork, and I'm going to do what it takes.
These people really care. These teachers, you know, they'll help you a lot. They never let your grades go down. If your grades go down, you get disciplined. I've had teachers chase me because I try to cut class. Mr. Schaefer, my U.S. history teacher, he's jumped a fence just to get me.
Peace, love, and granola.
Good.
Adieu to you and you.
Just let me say that I saw Miss Fields last week. She had come in because Keith had, you know, a C.
Since biotech teachers meet for lunch nearly every day, they can share impressions of their students and intervene early when they see trouble on the horizon.
I'm just sorry that we're here.
Keith is such a great kid and he's smart, but he's just not using what he's got.
You've got support from home, you've got the ability, you've got the support in this academy. There's no reason why you shouldn't be getting A's or B's.
I noticed my mom was mad at me, and she kind of explained that when we got home. And after that kind of clicked something, and I brought my grades up.
Keith's a very good example of how you can really turn a student around by just paying attention to them.
Or this is allele Y, this is allele X, or 1 and 2, as we talked about them.
Biotech students get additional support and attention outside the classroom from mentors at several biotech companies in Silicon Valley.
So we got an unexpected result. So this is what happens when you do science. Things happen that you don't understand. You have a hypothesis, something that we think is going to happen. You do the experiment to see what actually happens, and then you try to understand it to go back and change your hypothesis.
A lot of these students are of Latino background, so I think it helps them to see someone who comes from their culture as well, who's been able to progress in this particular career. So I think it makes it something that's more of an option for them.
Take 10 microliters from the small tube.
As a freshman, I just thought I was going to be a single mother and at my age at 16, or just be nothing.
For Erica Diaz, the decision to enter biotech changed her life.
As a sophomore, I said, I want to become a doctor. But to become a doctor, what do you have to do? You have to go to school. And I guess as that goal started reaching out, like started getting bigger for me. And every day is like a goal for me to be in class, to be in school, so I can reach that goal.
We had them in the light first, and then we covered the tank with like black paper so it can look dark in there, and then that's when they were more sexually active.
As the semester drew to a close, students came together to assist each other with preparations for their final presentations.
I think one thing in honors classes you often see is real competition. I'm working for that A+, I gotta, whereas here I think we see more cooperation. The students realize, hey, we're in this together, and doing group work projects, that we gotta do this together. I think that's a big advantage.
The intimacy of this school within a school and the group collaboration helped Bernice Rev Welton overcome her shyness to become a top student.
We just wanted to find out the easiest way to take DNA from a tarantula. So we did.
I was like antisocial. Didn't really get along with many people. But having with, you know, all these kids in the same room, like for three or more classes, you kind of get attached to them.
After a summer internship at Genentech, she plans to enter Chico State.
We wanted to see if over-the-counter steroids had the same effect as prescribed steroids.
Most of my family doesn't end up like in college and stuff, and all they know is like a medical assistant or something. And so me becoming like a biochemistry or something, they're gonna be like, wow, you're really doing something.
And these are the kind of folks that have the commitment, who are willing to put their time, their effort, their hearts out to students, because they understand that these students will return that same sort of commitment to them.
And these guys had a difficult time coming to school. They had a difficult time telling the truth. They had a difficult time keeping focused. And I'm so proud, and I don't want to cry right now, but Griffin!
For more information on what works in public education, go to edutopia.org.